Hello, it's Celia, and I hope you all are having a wonderful day. Today I will show you my TBR for the upcoming Booktubeathon. This is a yearly event hosted by Adrian Bissett, and it's a week-long readathon where the goal is to read as much as possible. Hopefully 7 books, but for me that is quite impossible, but I will try. And there are also a lot of challenges, so you can pick your TBR based on the challenges. And that's what I will do now. And I will of course leave links to everything in the info box. So let's get started. The first challenge is to flip a coin and let the coin decide what book you should start with. And I have decided to ease myself into this challenge or this readathon, because as I said, I rarely read like 7 books in a month, so 7 books in a week is not very likely, but as I said, I will give it a go. And the 2 books that I will be choosing from is 2 of the Penguin Modern Classic, or the minis. The first one, which will be The Head, is Shirley Jackson and The Missing Girl. This is a collection of 3 short stories, and in general I really like Shirley Jackson's writing. So this is The Head. And as the tail, or as the number side, I will go for Javier Marías, Madame du Deffaut and the Idiots. And this is 5 portraits of literary figures. It's about Nabokov and Emily Bronte and Madame du Deffaut, and yeah. So I'm really eager to read both of them. So this is the number. So let's see. It's a head. So that that means I will be reading Shirley Jackson, The Missing Girl first, and pleased with that. The next challenge is to read about something that you would like to do, and maybe this is a bit of a cheat, but I have went with Devotion by Patti Smith. This is about Patti Smith going to Paris, sitting at Café de Flore, watching people writing, and then she writes a short story. And I have been sitting a lot at cafes and read this summer, but I would really like to get into writing again. So, therefore, Devotion. Number 3 is to read a book and watch the movie adaptation. And I have chosen The Children of Men by P.T. James. This is the July pick of the book and movie reading group over at Memento Mori. And yeah, I'm behind. And I will read this book next week. And I'm not sure if I will be able to watch the movie. I haven't come across it yet, but if I do, I will watch it. I have watched the movie before though. It's been many years. I watched it in theaters when it was released. But this will be my first time reading the book. This is a dystopian. It was written in 1992 and is set in year 2021. And there hasn't been born a child in 25 years, so the human race is facing extinction and things happened. And there's also this young woman that is bearing a child. So yeah. Number 4 is read a book with green on the cover, and I have chosen Fatale by Ed Brubaker and Sean Phillips. This is a graphic novel or a comic. And it's very green on the cover. You can see the woman and the man. This is a mixture of noir and horror, especially Lovecraftian horror, as you can see the tentacles and everything. And that is all I know, basically. I heard only good things about Ed Brubaker as a writer. I think the artwork looks good, so yeah, super interested to get to this. Then we have the challenge to read a book while wearing the same hat. And for this challenge, I have chosen a pretty short book as well, because this hat is not the most comfortable hat to wear. I usually only wear hats during winter, and I only wear beanies. This is not a beanie. It's a sun hat, I think. It makes me feel like Anne of Green Gables. And while 7-year-old me would have loved that fact, I'm not sure. But yeah, this is the hat I'm going for. And the book I will be reading while wearing this hat is A Life's Music by Andre McKinn. And this is a novella. Andre McKinn is Russian, but he writes in French. So this has been translated from the French by Geoffrey Strachan. And this is set in the Soviet Union. The narrator has stranded on this railway station. It's a lot of snow. And he comes across an old man playing the piano in the dark while crying. And later on, the old man tells his story. And this is a story of loss, love, and survival that movingly illustrates the strength of human resilience. Yeah, I think I will love this book. It sounds so good. Number six is read a book with a beautiful spine. And I have chosen this beautiful spine. And this is The Tyranny of Lost Things by Rhiannon Lucy Coslett. This is about a woman who goes back to her childhood home. She has a lot of nightmares. There are things she doesn't remember, and she needs to find out what has happened. It's about, as I said, growing up, coming of age. It's about trauma, and yeah, it really sounds like a book for me, so I hope it will be. So, fingers crossed. The last challenge is to read 7 books. I have 6 books here, and I have chosen 2 so I can have something to choose from. The first is Hiroshima, Mon Amour by Margrit Duras. This is a screenplay. I haven't watched the movie, but I have been convinced that I can read it anyway. And it's Duras. I need to read it. And the other one is Quartet by Jean Rhys, and this is set in Paris, so it will be perfect if I read it next week. So yeah. So here are the books. It's A Missing Girl by Shirley Jackson, Devotion by Patti Smith, Children of Men by P.G. James, Fatal by Ed Brubaker and Sean Phillips, A Life's Music by Andre McKinn, The Tyranny of Lost Things by Rhiannon Lucy Coslett, and last but not least, Hiroshima, Mon Amour by Margrit Duras, and Quartet by Jean Rhys. So yeah, that was my TBR for the upcoming Booktubeathon. Are you participating in the Booktubeathon, and have you made the TBR? Please direct me to your videos. I would love to watch them. And yeah, have you read any of these books? I'm curious to know what you thought of them, of course. I'm always curious. But yeah. Thank you so much for watching, and until next time, ha det!